My name is Steve Forde. I'm the Senior Product Manager for Adobe After Effects. And in this technology sneak preview, I'm going to show you something really cool we've been working on called the Warp Stabilizer. Now, the Warp Stabilizer is designed to replace the original stabilizer in After Effects, but also take stabilization of footage that's not shot in the best of conditions to a whole new level. Let me show you what I mean. Here's some footage that was shot on a beach with a handheld. Now, as I play this back, you'll notice that it's not the best from a viewing perspective, nor is it really able to be used in a production environment. Essentially, the Warp Stabilizer is very simple. I'm going to take this footage and I'm going to drag and drop it onto a comp. And then what's going to happen is I'm going to apply the Warp Stabilizer effect right onto the footage. It's drag and drop. The analyzing of the footage takes place completely in the background, so I'm not locked out of After Effects. As an example, I can continue to work in AE while the analyzing of the footage takes place. Now that the Warp Stabilizer has finished analyzing the footage, let's take a look at what we have. As I play it back, you'll notice now that the footage almost looks like it was shot with a dolly or a Steadicam. It's that smooth. And the Warp Stabilizer has done this all automatically in the background while I continue to work in After Effects. And just to give you an idea of how much work the Warp Stabilizer actually had to do, I'm going to change one of the options here. And I'm going to say Stabilize Only. What this will do is basically get rid of any auto-cropping or scaling of the image and show you the actual areas of the frame it had to adjust while the stabilization takes place. So as I play that back, you'll see the block around the edge of the frame. Essentially, these are all the areas that the Warp Stabilizer had to take in place. But the key is that the Warp Stabilizer doesn't need to deliver just that as a final result. Again, by switching back to Stabilize, Crop, and Auto Scale, what it does is it fills the frame, fills it entirely with the image, and allows me to look at a steady shot. Now, since this is a technology sneak preview, I'm going to go beyond and give you a really in-depth look of what's happening under the hood. As an example, I'm going to show you this footage from the Brooklyn Bridge. Now, as I play this footage, again, this was shot with a flip cam as somebody was walking down the bridge. Essentially, you're getting that natural left and right movement as somebody walks and holding the cam. Now, how does the Warp Stabilizer deal with that? I'm going to show you under the hood a little bit what it's doing. Essentially, I'm going to bring this up and I'm going to go into an area that's just very experimental. And I'm going to show you all the tracks that Warp Stabilizer has applied to the clip and play that back. Now, as you can see, all of these track points have been added completely automatically in the background by the Warp Stabilizer and is the key to the information of how the Warp Stabilizer does what it does. It's how it can do this without creating a lot of additional artifacts that you may see with some other stabilizers or with After Effects' original stabilizer to begin with. So let's see what the Warp Stabilizer does with this footage. I'm going to get rid of those track points. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the actual finished clip. And as you can see, the left and right movement that had naturally taken place is completely gone, and now I have a steady shot that almost again looks like it was done with a dolly or a Steadicam. Another really powerful feature of the Warp Stabilizer I want to show you is how it deals with this thing called the rolling shutter ripple effect. Now, rolling shutter comes from DSLRs and other digital cameras when they're shooting, and it has a dramatic effect on stabilization. In fact, most stabilizers can't deal with this correctly. And you wind up getting what I'm going to show you here. Essentially, you get this ripple that happens up that's really artifacted by that window there. And it looks terrible. In fact, it's made the stabilized footage even worse than the footage that I had to work with at the beginning. Warp Stabilizer takes that to a whole new level. Essentially, we can get rid of that artifacting and deal with it very cleanly. And I'll show you in this composition. As I bring this over, you'll notice over in the effect controls that I have this rolling shutter ripple effect, and I can do enhanced reduction. So it'll start stabilizing, and as you will see, when I play this, you'll notice that the ripple that was there from the previous stabilization is now completely gone as a result of how the Warp Stabilizer takes information from frames before and after the current time point and uses that to predict what the next frame needs to be. And this is, again, something that has never been seen before in After Effects and, frankly, is nowhere else in the market. The last thing I want to show you is specifically for editors. For those, as I jump over to Premiere Pro, for those folks who may not be familiar with After Effects, one of the things that, again, as an editor I may run into is, in this case, I have some footage that doesn't really match in terms of its stable capability with the rest of the sequence that I'm working on. After Effects and Premiere Pro share this really common feature called dynamic link. And as an example of, as I go to this clip and I right click and choose replace with After Effects composition, that takes me right over to After Effects and allows me, in this case, to apply the warp stabilizer right within AE. Again, I don't really even need to know too much about After Effects. I just need to drag and drop and then return to Premiere Pro. And as you'll notice, the footage is being completely done in the background while I can continue to work in Premiere Pro without any impact to the workflow as I work. This has been a technology sneak preview of a new feature we're working on at Adobe called the Warp Stabilizer.